Now this morning, we're going to speak to you, we are in Easter, we're going to speak to you about the way of the cross, the way of destiny. The way of the cross is the way of destiny. I am, from the beginning of the year, I am in a prophetic flow. Because this year is a very prophetic year. 5777. 5, the number of grace. 777, completion. Also the number of the Holy Spirit. Completion. If you look in the book of Revelation and all over in the Bible, you'll see that 7 is a very prominent number of the Lord. So 5777. 5 means the grace taking us to completion. Grace bringing us into the fullness of what God wants to do. So we are expecting a mighty move of the Holy Spirit. We can read from the Bible that there's coming an outpouring of the Holy Spirit in the end times that is going to be double as powerful as the outpouring of the Pentecost day, on the Feast of Pentecost, 2,000 years ago. It is going to be the former rain and the latter rain together. We are so privileged to receive or to live in the end times because we are receiving the former and the latter rain together. Can you say amen? So we are not surprised. We are receiving rain. We are receiving in the natural. We've received a lot of rain. They said this year is going to be a very dry year, you know, and El Nino is going to rule. And we said, no, El Shaddai is going to rule. El Shaddai, our God is going to rule. And the Lord opened the clouds and the dams are full. Not all the dams. I know certain places in the country are still very dry. But they need to pray. They need to call upon the name of the Lord. They need to stand on the word of the Lord. They need to stand on the name of the Lord. Can you say amen? Bloemfontein is not going to be the same again. Amen. Praise God. So this morning, we're going to flow in the... We are in Easter. But we are going to focus still on the prophetic. Because God is busy with something extraordinary. It's not normal what God is busy with. And we need to understand that. So this morning, I'm going to speak to you the way of the cross, the way of destiny. Say to somebody next to you, you have got a destiny. Jaco, you can get that clip ready for me, please. We're going to look at a video clip. And after that, we'll take it from there. Okay. Are you ready for us? Right, let's look at this video clip. Can we switch off the lights, please?
Ayo, ayo. Badi. Haki. Laithai lanna kuli oma. E amos. Badi. Ha.
In chede. Come on. Hey. Chede.
Gum. You deus.
Thank you.
Gesù now. Gavar.
Gavar, no. Gavar, no. Prego.
Non le re com o ana amel com te hevon le re com titalon le da fe com gavel di hen te hevon a vin le com ma tabdina. Atala Nishmati have Alanatha and Nashla Lakea Nishmiti Mini Lahene Heva Miniana Itha by a die Lameva or by a diamond dove Milkacha Naminaba.
So this morning we're going to focus on what happened to Simon from Cyrene. Now let's read here in the book of Mark, chapter 15, verse 20. When they had finished mocking him, they took off the purple robe and put his own clothes back on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. On the way, they met a man named Simon, who was coming into the city from the country. And the soldiers forced him to carry Jesus' cross. Simon was from Cyrene and was the father of Alexander and Rufus. They took Jesus to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. The cross, the way of the cross, the way of destiny. We all are destined. If you belong to God, you've got a destiny. We all have got a destiny. What is happening in the world today, what is happening in South Africa, is all about destiny, our destiny. What is destiny? Now, many people have got many ideas concerning destiny. The world has got its own ideas concerning destiny. In Afrikaans, bestemming. Your ain't bestemming. We are all going somewhere. There's an eternal destiny, which is heaven or hell. But in this way of the cross, God is taking us on a journey. He's taking us on this way, a certain way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody, no one comes to the Father except by me. There is no other way to life. There is no other way to eternal life. No matter how or what man says or what man tries to get to God. Jesus himself said, there is no other way. I am the only way. Buddha is not the way. Muhammad is not the way. Krishna is not the way. Religion is not the way. I am the way. Jesus said, I am the way to the Father. I am the way to eternal life. No one comes to the Father except through me. What is destiny? Now let me show a couple of things people say. They say destiny is no matter of chance. It is a matter of choice. It is not a thing to be waited for. It is a thing to be achieved. William Jennings Bryan, this is what he said. Another person says, it's in your moments of decision that your destiny is shaped. In the moments of your decision, your destiny is shaped. Another one says, love is our true destiny. We do not find the meaning of life by ourselves alone. We find it with another. Things to just think about. But I want us this morning to look at something different. Divine destiny comes by the way of the cross. There is a divine destiny. All people have destiny. But I'm speaking this morning about divine destiny. God has designed a destiny for his people from the beginning. He has planned, he has strategized a destiny for those who believe in him, for those who put their faith and their trust in him, for those who come to the Son to be saved. It is God's way. It is not man's way. It is God's plan. It is God's strategy. It's not man's plan or man's strategy. Man's plans and man's strategies cannot make it. Man cannot find his way back to God by himself. It is God reaching out to us. It is God that who reached out to us through the cross. He came to us and he revealed his plan, his way, his strategy to us, so that we can accept it, because it is by faith. Can you say amen? It comes from the Lord through grace, but we receive it by faith. Now, unless we find the cross, we will never find our meaning and purpose of life. It is all in the cross. If you are a believer this morning, your destiny, your purpose, your future, everything is hidden in the power of the cross of Jesus Christ. Can you say amen here this morning? Outside of that, you will never know what your purpose is here on this planet. You will never know what the meaning of your life is on this planet. You'll run around, you'll search around, but you'll never come to your purpose and finally your destiny. It is only through the cross of Christ that it is revealed to you, that it is released to us as children of God. Jesus and Simon, both of them, on that day, 2,000 years ago, they were both on their way to somewhere. Jesus, a Jew, but also the Son of God, who came into the world for this purpose. The Bible says the Son of God was manifested to destroy the works of the devil. That's why he came. That was his purpose. He was on his way to his destiny. He was on his way to fulfill his divine purpose. He was on his way out of the city, Jerusalem, taken, brutally beaten by the Romans, and they were taking him out of the city to Golgotha, that place where you would be crucified. And then we see this man, Simon, also a Jew. Simon, a black man from Africa, coming from Cyrene, place in Libya. He was not going out of Jerusalem, but he was coming into Jerusalem. And then something happened. There was a coming together. One man coming from Africa into Jerusalem. One man coming out of Jerusalem, going to the cross. Was it fate or was it destiny? I'm asking you because I want you to think about this. Africa is in a time of destiny. Who knows how many Simons in Israel? Even Peter was called Simon Barjona. God could have organized for Simon, or one of the disciples, to carry the cross. But God did it his way. God planned it his way. We see here Simon. And I think Simon, like many other Jewish men, they've prepared themselves to come up to the feast of Passover, bringing their lamb for their families, Simon with his two sons. And maybe he started his journey maybe a couple of weeks before that. He started leaving from Africa, started traveling with his two boys towards Jerusalem to go to the yearly Passover feast where all men had to bring a sacrifice, all Jewish men. So like many other Jewish men, he was going to Jerusalem, to go to the Passover feast, to go and make the yearly sacrifice. Now just think about this. It took him a long time of traveling, getting there. And then, coming into the city, seeing people coming out, people streaming out. And this one man that was carrying a cross, or trying to carry the cross, and was beaten. And all of a sudden, somebody pulled him aside and said, "Come on, you, carry the cross." All of a sudden, his direction was changed. He was going in, probably to the temple area where the sacrifices were taking place. But all of a sudden, his whole journey was like, for him, was interrupted. He was not planning to go back out. He was planning to go in. He was planning to go to the temple site where he would bring his sacrifice. But then he was forced, the Bible said, by the Roman soldiers to help Jesus carry his cross. So we see in this, Simon was positioned because he was in the right place at the right time. Was this fate? Was this coincidence? I don't believe so. I believe it was planned by the Almighty God. I believe it was planned before even the beginning of time, when it was all in the mind of God. The life of Simon, his footsteps, everything was planned. A man coming from Africa to meet the Messiah on his way to the cross, to meet Jesus as he was coming out, so weak that he could hardly walk. He had to carry his cross. So the way of the cross, we need to understand, is that the cross will always position us for God's destiny in our life. We can never stay the same. We can never head in the same direction if we find the cross. If we find the cross, our direction of life is going to change. Can you say amen? We are not going to be the same person anymore. We are not going to head the same way anymore. We are going to have a U-turn. We are going to have, say to somebody, you will have a U-turn. Because the cross will position you so that you can be in the right time at the right place for God. This is what happened to Simon. I'm concerned, and there are many pastors that are concerned about messages that are preached in the end times. Messages that call upon people just to give your heart to Jesus and everything is okay. Messages without repentance. It is not biblical. The message of the cross, the message of the Bible is repent. Believe and repent. Can you say amen? Turn away. Turn away from your wicked ways. This is what the Bible teaches. Turn away from going the wrong way. Turn away from doing your own thing. Turn away from living your own life. Turn away from trying to sort out and find out what your own destiny is. Turn away and turn to God. Supernaturally, God orchestrated the life of Simon. There's something in it for me that when I look prophetically, Simon, a black man, was the first man that was touched by the cross. Come on now. Simon was the first man that was touched by the love of the cross. Can you say amen? And in that, I see God having a destiny for Africa. Because you can never do something for God and He will not reward you for it. Come on now. And maybe, just maybe, we are in that year where God is saying to Africa, when I needed you in Jerusalem, you came to help me. Come on now. You need me now. I'm going to come and help you. Praise God! Praise God! Praise God! Praise God! It's not the first time that Jesus was helped by Africa. The first time He was helped was when He was still a baby. And in those days, Herod wanted to kill all the babies. Jesus and his parents took Him to Africa. And He stayed there until Herod died. And I want to say this morning, Africa belongs to King Jesus. Africa does not belong to the devil. Why? Because there was an African man alongside the Messiah, helping him to carry his cross. Can you say amen? Helping him to carry his cross. And he was smeared in the blood of the Lamb of God. And he looked into the face of the Son of God. And experienced the love of the Son of God. I tell you, Simon's life was changed. In the kingdom of God, there is no racism. Before God, all men are equal. God loves all people. When Jesus died on the cross, He didn't only die for the Jews, The Jews thought, those Jewish believers, even Peter and those, they thought that the Messiah would only come for the Jewish people. But they were wrong. The Bible says, for God so loved the world. He so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. So whoever will believe in Him shall be saved. Amen. So, you know, brothers and sisters, when we look at the Bible, we can see in the kingdom of God, in Christ Jesus, there is no more man or wife or Greek or Jew or African. We are saved by the blood of Jesus. We belong to Jesus. Can you say amen this morning? Because our hearts are changed. Our hearts are changed. He was positioned. God was busy changing the heart also of Simon. The cross will position us in this way. The heart of stone will be cut out. The heart of stone will be cut out. And God will give us a new heart. Heart of love. Can you say amen? The heart of hatred is cut out by the way of the cross. So Simon was positioned. That was the number the first important thing in his life. Positioned by God. Number two, he was poked. Say to somebody next to you, you are going to get poked. I can see in my mind's eye, we didn't see it here, but when he didn't want to carry the cross, because he was, first of all, when they told him, you must carry the cross, he was reluctant, he didn't want to. This is where the little clip started there. And they had some spears. You know, nobody's going to say no to a spear. Can you say amen? He was, you know, we are reluctant. Even after we came to Christ, we are still reluctant to go the way of God. Can you say amen? We are still reluctant to reach out, to move forward into our destiny. And sometimes God needs just to, He needs to help us. He needs to poke us a little bit. Come on now. And he was poked. And finally he realized, listen, I'm not going to get away from this alive. I need to pick up the cross here. And so he picked up the cross. Because this is what the cross will do in our lives. The cross will poke us. Can I say to somebody, the cross will poke you. I'm speaking about the working of the cross. I'm speaking about the working of the Holy Spirit through the cross. There are some things in our lives that God will get rid of. Can you say amen? Like unforgiveness, resentment, hatred, all this selfishness, all these things. And God will bring us into situations where He will deal with those things in our life. The way of the cross. Why? Because God is taking us to His divine destiny. Come on now. The way of the cross. We won't walk the way of the cross by ourselves. We need some poking. Jesus said, if you want to be my disciple, you need to pick up your cross every day. Because the cross is an instrument of death. It's taking us somewhere. It's killing off the old sinful man. Amen. So that the new image of Christ can be formed in us. Number three, Simon was predestined for Jesus. Say, he was predestined. So are you and me. He was predestined for Jesus. The way of the cross will predestine us for Jesus. Not for ourselves. Long before Simon was even born, he was in the mind of Christ, or in the mind of God. And God said, I need a man. I need somebody. That day, way, way, way in the future, when the Lamb of God is coming out of Jerusalem, and the Lamb of God is so weak that he can't carry the cross, I will need somebody that will fulfill my plans and my purposes. I will need somebody that I can create, that I can put it into his heart, and I will prepare him. So that he will be right there at the right time for my son, to help my son to carry his cross. So what I'll do, I'll make Simon. Simon was predestined to carry the cross. That's why I'm speaking about a little bit about predestination. Because many of you come from churches or the background of predestination. Now let me tell you something this morning. Predestination is only in Christ. Out of Christ there is no predestination. You need to be in covenant with God. So what happened? Simon was predestined. He didn't even realize that. The first day when he started packing his things, got everything together, he was on his way to Jerusalem to sacrifice. He didn't even know about the Messiah. He knew nothing. So he came in there. And then all of a sudden, something changed. Something was forced upon him. Predestination. And when God called Simon out of Africa, in his mind, he was not just seeing Simon. He was seeing millions and millions and millions of Africans. Come on. He was seeing millions and millions and millions of Africans. Come on. Come on. You need to see it this morning. He was seeing millions and millions and millions of Africans that are going to be saved. We are in the right continent at the right time. Can you say amen here this morning? Say to somebody next to you, you are at the right place at the right time. Expect God to do miracles in your life. That's why we are so excited. Are we expecting a wave of God's grace to come over Africa, just to fall upon Africa, that is going to destroy all hatred and all murder? Can you say? And every evil thing of the devil. Because Jesus paid the price and he found a man by the name of Simon from Cyrene that helped him. And I believe in the end time, the Holy Spirit is our helper. In the end time, the Holy Spirit is going to help the church in Africa. So there's going to be a mighty revival in Africa and millions upon millions. And listen, Africa has got millions of people, but there are many that belong to Allah, who is a no God. So he was predestined to help Jesus to carry the cross. Now, by the cross of Christ, number one, I'm going to close now. We are positioned for our kingdom purpose. Now I'm speaking to you, child of God. By the cross, we get positioned for our kingdom purpose. When you come to the Lord Jesus Christ, your kingdom purpose begins to unfold. There is a kingdom purpose for your life. Can you say amen? That's why you come to church. That's why you belong to a home group. And here we read here in Ephesians 2 verse 10. God has made us what we are. And in our union with Christ Jesus, He has created us for a life of good deeds. He has created us for a life of kindness. You can put in the word kindness. In Christ Jesus, your divine purpose, your kingdom purpose is to live a life of good deeds. It is to live a life of kindness to all people. Kindness even to your enemies. Come on, can you say amen? Even your enemies. Outside of the cross, it's not possible. But the way of the cross helps us to forgive somebody. The way of the cross helps us to bless somebody, even if they've cursed us. It is only through the cross that we can do that. South Africa's future, listen, I'm bringing it together because we're in the flow. South Africa's future is not in the hand of the government. South Africa's future is in the hand of the church. It is the church who is going to determine the future of South Africa. The church who prays, the church who shines the light. That is the church that will overcome. That is the church that will determine Africa's future. The Bible says here that, let me just read it again, that we are in union with Christ Jesus. He has created us for a life of good deeds, which He has already prepared for us to do. He has, just like Simon, God has long ago, even before you were saved, in His mind, He had a plan, He had a purpose for you. He had all the good deeds that you need to do. He had it in mind. So once you come to the cross, the day you find the cross, God releases you. He positions you for that purpose, for that kingdom purpose, so that all those good works that He wants to fulfill in your life will be fulfilled. Do you get that here this morning? Number two, we are poked to become like Him. Say to somebody, you are going to be like Jesus. If you like it or not. Come on. How are you going to be like Jesus? In your nature, in your character. You are going to be just like Jesus because God is changing you from the inside out. He's making you a lovable person. He's taken out the heart of stone. He's given you the ability to forgive somebody else. He's given you the ability to love even unlovable people. Can you say amen here? He's given you the ability through the power of the cross. This is the way of the cross. So you will be poked on the way to become like Him. How will you be poked? You'll be poked by this world. You'll be poked by tribulations. You will be poked in circumstances, things happening in your life. A taxi just coming in front of you, you know, pushing you off the road, things like that, poking you to become more like Jesus. Instead of, you know, showing the guy a fist and swearing and cursing, you're saying, bless you, brother. God loves you. I love you. Jesus is with me. Can you say amen? It is the way of the cross. God will poke you. He'll begin to change you through these things happening in your life. Why? Because He's poking you to become like Him. Those whom God had already chosen, He also set apart. You are set apart to become like His Son, so that the Son would be the eldest brother in a large family. Praise God. Number three, we are predestined for His glory. This is so powerful. This is so wonderful. This is where God is going with us. It's not just poking all the way. God is bringing us to our destiny. And I believe we are very close to our destiny. The Bible says here, your real life is Christ. And when He appears, then you too will appear with Him and share His glory. You see, this is what it's all about. He's the destiny, that which God has prepared for us. The Bible says we have all sinned and we fall short of the glory of God. But God in the cross, in the way of the cross, He has restored that. He's bringing us back to our destiny. God is bringing us back to that place where we'll share in the glory of Christ. Let's stand here this morning. Not in me. No. Now this morning, I want to ask you, let's just for a moment, let's just close our eyes. Because we will miss the purpose of Passover if I don't give a chance to people this morning to step into the way of the cross, into the way of destiny. And for a moment, I just want everybody just to close your eyes. Just help me. Just close your eyes for a moment. And I want to speak to those people. And I want to say to you, brother or sister, if you are here today and you are living a life of religion, I want to call you to this morning and say, come to the cross. South Africa is a very religious nation. It is a very religious country. There are many people living in South Africa that go to church every Sunday, but their lives do not reflect the Lord Jesus Christ. They have not got the power of the cross in their lives. Why? Because they've never heard the gospel of Jesus the proper way. The proper way of the gospel is this. Everyone needs to come to the cross of salvation. Everyone needs to come to that point where we surrender ourselves, give our lives over to Jesus. We need to come to that place where we are finished in ourselves. This morning, while every eye is closed, I want to ask you this morning, if you want God to come into your life and change your life, change your direction, won't you just raise your hand? We're going to pray for you this morning. Somebody here that God is speaking to you this morning and He's calling you by His love and say, come to me this morning. Come to me, because your plans will come to nothing, but my plan will bring you into glory. My plan will bring you into your destiny. Is there anybody? Is there anybody? Just raise your hand so I can see this morning. Is there anybody? Okay. Is there anybody there? Just raise up your hand. Let me see. There's a hand there. Anybody? There's a hand. Thank you for the hand. Thank you for the hands. Just help me. Just help me. Thank you for the hands. Amen. I don't want those people to come out, but I want somebody to go and stand with the people that has put up their hands. Just keep up your hands so we can see. I just want somebody to stand there with you. Go and stand there with that person there, raising their hand. Please. We just want to say. Because, you see, the message of the cross is the message of salvation. It's the message of hope. This morning, God wants to save you. And we're all going to pray together with those people who have raised their hands. Let's just pray now. Can you just pray with me, please? And pray with them now. Say, Father, I come to you today and I repent. I turn away from my old life. I surrender my life to you. Lord, thank you for dying for me on the cross. I believe with my heart and confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. And today, Lord Jesus, I ask you, come into my life, take control. I surrender myself to you. And right now, I believe I'm saved. In Jesus' name. Amen.